Alright, so we broke off when Ephesus was taking me through his music, is very cool and all that. Right now, I want us to look at the comedy side of you. You've posted so many videos of yourself. I don't know whether it's ads or something, but there's some comedy bit of you.
Yeah.
Would you prefer to be a comedian than a musician?
People think that I should be a comedian than a musician, but those are people who don't understand humor.
Oh, yeah.
So when they don't understand humor, if you're a funny guy, it does not mean that you should go and do stand-up comedy. You're just a funny guy. Not every funny guy actually goes and does stand-up, you know?
Yeah.
But you could be funny. I have people in my family who are very funny. It's part of who we are.
Yeah.
Most of the people in our family have jokes. I'm just being honest with you. We are happy people and we have so many jokes. So for me, that is just nature for our family.
Mm.
And I do not see that as a career, but I know I can do comedy. I know I can do acting.
Mm.
You know, I know I could do stand-up. I'm probably better than some Ugandan comedians.
Yeah.
If I decided to do it. I am very good with words. If you go find my friends that I used to be with at school, they'll tell you that is one of the most funniest guys I've ever seen. And that's it. But it does not mean that I am a comedian. I just happen to be a funny guy. But I do music as a career.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So, and with some of the funny things I do ads for Jumia. I do ads for other companies. Not even, though I prefer not to do so much for so many people.
Mm-hmm.
Because it just overweighs the brand and you have too much promo than you being an artist.
Mm-hmm.
So it just takes away from the
you
brand as well.
You lose yourself in that.
Yes, you shouldn't do too much as well. But I try my best. And you can see that as an artist, for me, I think it's good to have your personality. An artist, personality, performance, you know, you need all that stuff. You cannot be that guy who does not have a personality. And where some things fail, you can bring other things. They can be bigger and help you. You know,
I've seen you go to Pastor Bugembe's church.
Yeah.
You're born again. Why?
Not entirely. I'm a very faith-oriented man, and I'm very spiritual with God. I'm very deep with that, and I thank God every day. I forgot to pray last night. Oh my God. But which is bad. It's not good. But I thank
so
God. I don't
really
pray, but I thank God for every day.
Oh,
you
yeah.
know, every morning when you wake up,
mm-hmm.
you know, you have to be thankful. And I'm a very faith-oriented person. My mom is a pastor, though my dad is actually a Muslim. You know, like we have like a split kind of thing, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, I'm not really split with everything. I'm very faithful to God and I'm very thankful. I think God should not be cocooned into a religion.
Yeah.
Oh, you have to be this or you have to be that. You just have to be a human being who happens to love God.
As long as you know what you want.
As long as you know what you want. It's amazing. And for me, that's it, you know. And I went, pastor invited me. So we scheduled, he'd invited me two months prior, but I had no time. So I told him when I think I'll be free.
Mm-hmm.
And he was very kind to host me. You know, and I went and said my words. You know?
And you preached?
Yeah, I can preach.
You can?
Even at school, I used to preach, actually, in my primary. I used to pray for kids. I used to preach. And that has never left me. I'm that kind of guy. Though so many people may not know that side of me.
I believe they don't.
Which is okay because you shouldn't know everything.
You
shouldn't know everything. But in the end, I went, I preached, we talked, we had conversation, deep stuff and all that. We had time to even look at the church, to look around and see, you know, with what they've done. And I'm very happy that
How
Pastor does.
How many times have you been there?
Once. That was the first time I've been to Pastor Bugembe's church.
So you...
I passed by, but I never, I'd never been there.
You wish to go back and preach the word?
You never know. You never know.
Well, I've had stories. I have seen you post about Martha Kay and all of that. I don't know. I don't know whether you're the brother or you're the boyfriend. Take us through that.
That's a bunch of people. That stuff like on the internet for fun, for people to laugh at. Martha Kay is an amazing person. I think she's cool.
So you guys are not dating?
No. No, I'm not dating anyone, actually. I'm a very single guy. And I'm not searching. I'm just single and watching.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
You're still looking for the right one?
No, really. If something comes up,
mm-hmm.
you know. Energy, you know. You know that.
Okay.
That, that kind of energy, if it comes to you, know. It just feels like it's different and you feel like this is the person. It shouldn't really be like, oh, you know what, you're searching and you're looking for
like
girls and you're trying so and so on the next person.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like if the time comes and the energy comes through and you feel like, you know, a wave comes and you feel like this person has an aura around them
mm-hmm.
that I like and that person feels the same way, and probably like you start going out and you meet up, you start getting to know each other, and maybe things work. You know, some things may not work. Like, we've all had relationships, but sometimes things don't work. But
yeah.
you try, you know, and it comes down to the energy. And for me, I'm happy with not being in a relationship with Martha Kay. I believe she's doing something with her life as well, and doing stuff with whoever she's with,
mm-hmm.
you know, who I don't know, because I'm not deep into her life, you know. I see her when I see her, like, mm-hmm. let's say we're at the saloon and we meet. Or like I went to her niece's birthday party, you know, and it was a good vibe. That's how we did the videos, we took the pictures. It was an amazing time. And we had conversation. I sat with her, we talked. Yeah, she's a cool person. So for me, that's what I see. I don't know so much about other things, or this and that and that and that. Or this is how she lives life, this is how she moves, or she, oh, we're dating, or those are things I don't know, and that has not happened yet. But if it happens,
mm.
it would be a good experience as well. She looks juicy.
Oh, yeah. Mm. Why not? There was also something else on the timeline about you and Faiza
is fun.
They actually put you guys in the news, I saw sometimes.
Yeah, she's a really fun person. I like that she can role play. I role play a lot on the internet.
Oh, yeah,
so for me, I think she's fun. I love her energy, and she's soft. I really, I had her once. She's so soft. She's juicy as well.
Juicy, like. Thank you. Okay.
I still remember, like, Faiza, mm-hmm. you're really juicy. I want you to know that.
I believe she get the message right.
Faiza, you know that. Really juicy. We met at my show. She at Boston, right?
Oh.
Yeah, it was a good experience. She was so happy. She was actually enjoying the show, so I saw her enjoy. Having fun, and after the show, I usually come into the fans and say thank you. Like, I try to greet anyone who has like a positive energy. I come mm-hmm. to them and say hello, thank you for supporting, thank you for being around, and all that. So I linked up with her. It was a good experience. You know, it was the first time we actually met and had a small chat. But I would love to meet her more. I think she should come here one time, and maybe we have like a conversation, maybe an interview or something on her personal thing.
Oh yeah, good.
Yeah.
Apart from, okay, how the way we look at social media, do you think it has helped a lot in your music?
It has.
Pushing your music?
Yes, it's one of the biggest things that has helped me get there. Because I remember when I was starting my career, so many of the DJs never wanted to play my music.
Mm.
Big up to the DJs who never wanted to play my music. I forced you to play it.
They never played it.
Yes, I changed my method. I said, you know what, let me just make sure I send them emails.
Oh.
And
so what's the difference?
The difference is that you don't meet me and you don't have anything to say, or you won't ask for money, you won't do anything. Quick advice to the young artists, send them emails.
But when you send the emails, I think they can get back to you.
You could ignore it or not ignore it. It's up to you. I don't care. Thank you. I sent it, so I tried my best. It's like if I like you, I'd say, oh wow, you look amazing, I like you. And I would love us to go for a date. Yes, you can choose to ignore, but I tried my best.
So they either play it or they ignore.
Yes, it's fine, but you got the message. Yes.
Exactly. And then most people think that you're proud because you don't follow back people on Twitter.
On Twitter? Yes. But I follow people everywhere on Instagram.
No. Yes, you follow on IG.
So if they think that I am proud, common sense is something that they lack, and on top of that, their point of view is like a mirror to a blind man.
Mm.
It's useless. Yes, the mirror to a blind man is useless, so your point of view is useless.
But let me ask, why don't you follow anyone on Twitter?
I choose not to answer that because you see, on Twitter, I have my reasons as to why I don't follow people, and I will never tell anyone why I don't follow people on Twitter.
Oh my
I refuse
goodness.
To say that, actually. I refuse to answer that question. But the good thing is that I follow people on Instagram.
Yeah,
I even follow people who don't follow me. There are so many artists who don't follow me, but I've gotten time to understand that they don't follow me, and I'm trying to make sure I unfollow them because I know they have a little, they are salty. So many artists don't like me. They pretend
that they like it.
Yes, it's because I'm too good. So they have this kind of thing, you know what? I want you then follow me. Bichi, bichi, bichi. You like me, you search my name and find me. So they search my name, they find time to search, right? I am Epas. What is he doing now?
What is he saying?
But they don't follow me. I understand you're doing that. You're a salty guy, you're a salty lady. That's very fine. Keep it up. I don't care.
Keep
your mind
at Apart from music, what else takes your time when you're not doing music or you're not in studio? Let's say your free time or something like that.
Looking at hot girls on Instagram.
Jesus Christ.
I don't like the pictures though. Yeah, I don't like the pictures I see.
You just keep scrolling. You're more a stalker or something.
You're a stalker. I'm not really a stalker. That I left it to the other guys. But I see people, you know, like you see people and you're like, okay, she has a nice ass. She has a fine ass. I think she should work in the Ministry of Finance.
Oh, okay.
No, I see some girls. I've seen some on your status as well. I'm like, there's some girls you're standing with. Like you were in the middle and they were just there.
Yeah, I remember that picture. Wow.
But there are so many girls who look amazing. So for me, I like to see God's creations.
Mostly on Instagram.
Mostly ladies. I do not watch men. It's the other way around. Men watch me.
You're straight.
Straight like an arrow. Straight and narrow.
Yeah. Okay. Now, apart from you, you know, saying
stalking people, like what do I do else? Mm-hmm. I play games. You phone me, play games.
Yeah.
I play FIFA.
But I'm good at FIFA. I should.
You don't. You can't manage.
I can pitch it.
Trust me, you'll suffer.
It's okay.
So many people say, "Oh, I'll get him and beat him." I think you play me. So many people think because I do music, they think I'm not really good at. I have so many games and I play different games. I don't just play FIFA. I play very top action games that are very technical. Because they give you that problem solving kind of thing whereby with FIFA it's easy. It's clockwork, you know? It's like ABC. So it's easy. But when it comes to other games, probably different. I play games, I watch masterclasses, I read a lot. As you can see, I have a library here. And I learn a lot. I take learning very serious. So my time is well spent. I play with my dog when I need to. And that's a daily job. I have to feed my dog. I have to cook for it every day. And I do the normal stuff. I sleep like any other person. I sleep late. I go to studio. I make music. I watch movies. Currently I'm watching this series. People just put me on. Sometimes I don't want to watch them series, but they put me onto them. I'm watching Lucifer.
Oh Jesus! I don't know. I failed to watch that series.
I don't know why, but I'd like to watch it. Like it's quite interesting.
How many episodes have you
watched? I think I'm on episode one.
Yes, so there's 30.
I have all of them actually, most of them. I have up to maybe four or five. Mm. I'm not sure, but I have a couple of those. I'm watching 24 as well. Like it's an old one, but I
good to rewatch.
I ended at episode 5. Some people rewatch. I was with a lady here, she called Swabra, and she like yesterday. So she like, I rewatch movies and series.
I'm like,
you have time.
If I watch a series, maybe in Jan, I can rewatch it in June or July or something.
You
like
have
that.
Time.
But because it was interesting, you feel like you want to watch it
I
again.
I know, but the problem is that so much time is wasted. If you think about it. There's so much time wasted. So for me, sometimes I'm not really good at rewatching stuff. Because I feel like, okay, maybe that I pass, let me pass that. And maybe do something else. But I like to watch movies. And I sometimes I like to watch the translated ones, Junior, Jingo, you know, whoever, Mark, all these guys, like the local ones. I have those as well because I like to watch them. Those guys have jokes as well.
The horror, the horror bit.
Yeah, the horror bit of it when it's Jingo is so funny. Like it's so funny. Like, you know, even if it's inspector kind of stuff, like. Those guys will say stuff that is really fun, you know, like sometimes you get to it and it takes me back to going to Vivanda and watching movies as a kid.
Back in the days.
Yeah, so for me that is special. So I spend my time normally like any other person and most of my time I like to learn things. I love to learn things and have new experiences and I try not to be on social media so much. It's a bad place as well. Like it's good to use social media.
Actually, don't use social media notes.
Nah. It's one of those places where you go, but it's one of those places that can be so addictive that you're going to spend 9 to 12 hours on social media and not do things that are really practical. If I spent 9 hours reading, do you know what I would have learned? Wasting that time on IG, watching how a girl has a sweet bum.
Going through beautiful.
Yes, content. I do that very little. It's very mild. I don't want to waste my time on that thing. You know, that's how so many people feel like they've not gotten anywhere because they see other people getting somewhere, posting a life that is even fake.
Exactly.
They probably don't even live that life. I live the life I talk about. If I am even to say anything, I live it. I have a comfortable life, and I'm thankful. I'm thankful and I don't have so many things, but I'm fine with that. You know, I shouldn't have the most out of the world, but whatever I have, I'm thankful. Thank you, God, for blessing me with all this. And thank you, my parents, who are my God as well, for creating me and nurturing me to be the guy I am. And I am living the life. Thank you to all those people and thank you to the fans who keep pushing me, who keep supporting me, who keep making sure that I have some money to do stuff. Thank you to the companies who actually give me endorsements and all these things to work with them. And thank you to me for also being very hardworking to learn new things, to make sure that I'm in position to be wanted by other people. If I don't work on myself, no one needs you. You can't be used. You cannot be used if you're useless. You can only be used when you're useful.
Yeah, right.
You know, if you're useless, no one uses you. So you are only used when you're useful.
That's a good point. Going back to the music, how many albums do you have?
So I have more than 6,000 songs. So if we're talking about albums, I will have so many albums that will never get out. But when you think about the music itself, like the albums I've released, I've released two albums. I'm actually working on my other album. On Saturday, I'm meeting the guys. So we're trying to select some of the songs for the album.
So it will be like your third album?
It will be like my third. It's going to be small. My albums have been having 20 plus songs. But this particular one, we're going to do a little more. We're going to do a little more less. Compared to what we've been always doing. We've been doing too much. Right now, I just want to do an R&B album. It's very R&B. It's not really dancehall. It's growing the sweet side. Because people don't actually know that I can really be the same. Way past.
Some of us
know. Yeah, you kind of know. But when you think about it, the majority of the people see me as a dancehall artist. I'm not a dancehall artist.
Yeah, initially, that's what I thought.
Yeah, I'm very all-round. So I can do anything, pop, reggae, rock, you know.
So you
anything.
Want to give us something
different. Yeah, I want to give you something new, you know, give you a different experience of myself and also give you an experience of enjoying music in a different dimension. You know, it's all about the energy.
Wow. Okay, looking at your music still, you've never actually held a concert?
Yeah.
Why? Are you scared?
No. That's scared what people think. People think, oh, you're scared, your show will flop. My show can flop. And even if you go to that show and maybe, or you see pictures where the chairs are empty, just know we brought so many chairs. The show didn't flop. We just brought so many chairs.
That is a flop because people have to fill the chairs.
No, I brought so many chairs to the venue. If I brought less, the show would be packed. But it's because you see so many blank chairs does not mean the show didn't work. The people who are supposed to be there were there.
Yeah.
I do not need the whole world to be at my show.
So when should we expect?
I had a show this year, but
COVID happened.
Yeah, all this stuff happened. We're already planning But it's okay, things happen, there's always a reason. But this time year I've had a couple of shows as well, live shows.
Mm.
You've seen me on Roster Nine, you've seen me on Club Beats performing multiple songs. It shows that I am capable of doing a good show.
Okay.
You know? And
we're waiting for one.
Yes. Where people are out there and they're seeing me live and live in color. You know?
Okay.
I would love that as well. You know, and if it's 2021, it will be amazing because I was born on 21st December. So having like having like my show in the 21 of 2020 is amazing.
End of, yeah, right.
Is amazing. You know, it will be like that amazing time, like where it actually did a song that connects with my birthday, you know, birthday, like
Batman.
Yes, the Batman. Yes, I'm probably doing it in December. I would love to do it in December.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I would love it to be in December. You know, people say, oh, maybe we'll put it earlier, but I think December would be like fun for me because that is like close to my birthday. And that's like amazing if I did it in that month, whereby I have so many memories and moments with family. It would be amazing.
Talking about this year, 2020, COVID has affected very many people's businesses.
I know.
How has it affected you as a musician?
It's affected not just me. I don't think I wouldn't talk about myself.
Mm.
I think it has affected so many because living with, so many people are getting into debts and all this. I'm telling you, so some people are dead of depression. It's not corona. Depression.
Mm.
You know, frustration that nothing is getting back in line. You know, look at how the traffic jam is in town right now. I just feel like the government should be reasoning more.
Mm.
Like thinking about what they're trying to do. You cannot be having people go back home like as if it's break time. You know, like, There's so much commotion, so it just feels so bad. You know, they should be thinking way beyond what they are thinking and let people work.
Mm.
We can deal with this. We can try to deal with this, you know? But the lockdown and all these things and the curfew, it's just too much.
Now campaigns are open.
Yeah, and you know, coincidentally, that it is election year and you're doing all this stuff. You know, like, it's not a coincidence. These people are trying to milk out the situation. And for me, I just feel like it's not right, you know? Let's look at things the way they are, but let's try to make sure that we can move. If people are already moving like this, and no one is dying all that, why don't you let people work? You know, why don't you let people... I'm not just talking about us, the musicians. We've lost a lot. I would say I've lost a lot. But this is not about me, it's about the country, you know, as a whole. And I feel like they should let people go back to work. They should let people do their thing, you know. Just encourage them to put on their masks and all these things that they need to do for the meantime.
Social distance.
Yes, and all these things, but we cannot social distance for so long. We are human beings, and human beings need to be together. That's why you see so many houses in like urban centers, and you see so many people all together because that is how we are supposed to be. We are family, that's how we fight diseases.
Mm.
I will insist it is better when we are united, it's not better when we are actually disjointed. This is science and it's real life. So, if you have scientists who have not even studied very well to understand humans, we have a very big problem. But now it's not really about the scientists, it's more about the politicians because. You're looking at the time, you want a scientific election, you want all these things so that for you, you find ways to deal with your stuff that it makes it comfortable for you to do what you want to do.
If I say last words to the fans out there, your people, your loved ones?
Oh, my fans, I can only tell them thank you. There's not too much. And hold the strength. I know so many people are going through so much in times like now, but hold the strength. Things are not easy, probably not having your job again. You know, some of the people's jobs are destroyed and all that. And I just feel for the people. For me, my last word is hold the strength. Nothing is going to be easy at the times, but let's be thankful for life. And at the same time, let's hold more conversations and let's hold our politicians accountable for what is happening. My last words is that don't fear to vote when the time comes because we are getting into voting.
Mm.
But when you voted, find out and ask those people what they're really going to do for you. And if those people who were there before didn't do what they are supposed to do, please don't vote. Whether it's an MP, whatever they are, whether it's a president or whatever, it's your choice. I feel like people who support Museveni should. I feel like people who support Bobby should. And shouldn't be put under a microscope or a pistol. Don't support Museveni. Because for me, I like Bobby Wine. That's bullshit. You should not put people on a gunpoint to support what they don't want to support. Because you like something, it does not mean that I should like it. So I feel like people should be more respectful with other people's choices. But when you're voting, be careful to vote people who you think will do stuff for you. Ask them what they're going to do for you. Don't just vote because, oh, you know what, you need to vote because it's important. No. You need to vote because you're going to get something out of it. So that is my last word that I would say. Be vigilant. Choose who you have to choose. And see what they're saying. Read their mind. Ask them tough questions. Those who have not done well by you, ask them why they wouldn't do it. And ask them why they should go back and do what they have to do when they failed to do it for the last 5 years when they were voted in peace.
Exactly.
So that's my last word.
Oh, wow. You guys, I've had so much fun interacting with APAS. It's been awesome. I've learned a few things from you. It's a very funny guy, by the way. But we're going to compete here. I'm sure we need to beat you. Should get me my other side of the fierce and epic. Anyways, thank you so much, guys, for watching. It's been a very beautiful interview. I've learned so much, I can say, from APAS. And there's something I didn't know about you that I got to know about today. And I believe it's been the same for you. Thank you so much for watching. Share the video with your friends, family, relatives. And yes, till next time, your video's coming. Thank you. Thank you.